So welcome back to my channel. It is Christmas next week, so I wanted to do one more kind of holiday look. This is your green smoky eye. It will look good on any eye color, on you can pair it with lashes, no lashes, bold lip, no bold lip. My shirt has a lot of colors, so why do I always make that face? Well, my shirt has a lot of colors, so I was trying different lips and it wasn't really working. The look that I had in mind was with an orange lip, or like a not orange, but like a reddish, like an orange red with a green. And I've done it before and it looks really pretty, but it wasn't working with this. But you can pair it with whatever you like, but the eyes are gorgeous and I added a little shimmer in there in the center and it's just beautiful. So without further ado, here it is. To start priming my eyes, I'm using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NYX Eyeshadow Base in White, setting it with Blank Type Eyeshadow by MAC. Starting on my crease, I'm using Bobbi Brown Toast Eyeshadow with the E40 Sigma brush, just going in little circular motions and going back and forth. Remember, you don't have to be very precise with this. Then I'm going in with a soft brown eyeshadow by MAC with the Laura Mercier Finishing Eye Brush. Notice that I'm going a little bit lower, but I'm using the same motion. With the same brush, I'm going to use the Inglot 122R Rainbow Eyeshadow. I'm going to use that medium color, and I'm going to go over the same thing I did. You don't have to use the same eyeshadows I'm using. You can just use any warm eyeshadow you have. If you don't have any, I have even used bronzers for these kind of transitions. Just make sure you go back and blend in between steps because this is going to make your life so much easier after. For that pop of color, I'm using Inglot 433 eyeshadow and adding a little drop of the MAC Mixing Medium to make it pop even more. I'm using the brush 239 by MAC and I'm starting at the lash line and working my way up all the way to where those transition colors started to blend. Notice that I'm not taking it all the way to the inner corner this time, just in that mobile lid. Going back with that Laura Mercier brush without adding any extra product and blending the edges away. With a clean 239 brush, I'm using Inglot Eyeshadow 44, just pressing that color in the outer corner, and then going back with a 217 brush by MAC and blending it in. Repeat the step a couple of times, as many times as you need, so that it gives you that perfect dimension that you want. For the smokiness, I'm using Inglot Eyeshadow 62 with NARS number 12 brush. And oh boy, it is an Inglot day. But again, I'm pressing the color into the lashes in the outer corner and blending it in with a clean 217 brush. I know, I use a lot of brushes. It's a very bad habit of mine. Just make sure you don't go too high out because it could make it look a little muddy, but just repeat the steps a couple of times until it gives you the intensity that you want. And just because I'm crazy picky, I'm going back with a tiny bit of Bobbi Brown Toast eyeshadow and blending those edges on top. It wouldn't be Christmas if we didn't have shimmer, so I am adding this gold glitter eyeshadow in my inner corners to open up my eyes. Now to clean up any mess, I'm using a little bit of eye cream on a sponge and it gives you a perfect edge for the eyeshadow on the outside. Now I felt like that second green color was getting lost, so I went back and added a little bit more and then blended with another clean brush. This is a Real Techniques brush, but I don't know the name. Now with NARS Via Veneto Eyeliner, it's the larger than life eyeliner. It's going in the inside, in the waterline, upper and lower waterline. It's going to give your eyes a perfect intense smoky look. For eyeliner, I'm using Laura Mercier Cream Liner in Noir with that brush that I've had for a very long time that I can't even read the name, but it's perfect. Starting in the middle of the eye, I'm going to work my way out and then I'm going to follow that little edge that we created when we used the sponge to clean up the mess underneath. I'm using the other hand for tension, but again, try not to pull too much because your eyes are very sensitive and we don't want to get old too soon. I mean, we're all gonna get old, but let's do it as gracefully as possible. I take my sweet time with the eyeliner because my eyes are extremely uneven, so I have to work really hard to make them perfect.
For this look, I want the liner to be thinner in the inside, going to a thicker end. Always going back to that 266 MAC brush to make the edges perfectly sharp. For primer, I'm using Makeup Forever Smoothing Primer, and I dropped the cap. And then I try to squeeze product out, and it got everywhere, even in my nose. And then, as I'm putting it on, I look around, and my cat is playing with the cap like if it was a soccer ball. So that was interesting. So anyways, this primer actually does something. It makes my pores disappear, and it mattifies. At least I think so. For foundation, my current favorite is Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. I use the matte and poreless one. It's 120 and 128. One is more yellow than the other, and it's perfect. It blends in perfect. I'm using the Real Techniques sponge, which I have run underwater, squeezed all the water out, and then it's a little bit damped, and it's perfect. And don't forget to blend down your neck. Now to conceal. I'm using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in NC20 and Fit Me Concealer in number 10. And I'm blending it out with the same sponge. Number 10 is a tad darker than the Pro Longwear Concealer. So I like them mixed. I don't mix them all the time, but sometimes I do. And I'm using also a little bit of it around my nose because it gets a little red. And to set everything, the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish. Yes, I got that right. And I'm pressing the color with that Cosette brush number S120. For my brows, I don't do a lot because I already have full brows, but I like to color them in. It makes a huge difference. I'm using a little bit of Brune Eyeshadow by MAC. And then I brush them down first so I can see the top line better because naturally my hairs go down. And then I brush them up and it kind of teases the hair and it stays up. I know it sounds crazy, it's your brow, but I find it works. To highlight that brow bone, I'm using Shroom by MAC with another Real Techniques brush that I don't know the name of, but I will find out for you. And now for Le Bronze, always Laguna by NARS with the same brush, going from the top of your ear facing your mouth and letting the brush do the work. Don't push the product into your skin, softly, barely touching the skin, let the brush do the work for you. For blush, I'm using Gilda again with the same MAC brush and spread a little bit too much, so I'm just gonna blend that in with the same powder brush. Throwing some mascara on, this is L'Oreal Butterfly. And to complete this smoky look, I'm going in with that Inglot Rainbow Eyeshadow, that middle color, with the 219 brush by MAC. And then that black color, and while I multitask, wow, I'm gonna press that black color into the lashes and then blend it with that Sephora brush, that smudge brush. I think is number 14, if I'm not mistaken. You can take it lower if you want more intensity, but this is perfect for me. For that chunky shimmer on my cheeks, I'm using Champagne Pop by Jaclyn Hill with Becca. It goes on top of my cheeks, down my cupid's bow, and because we used a good primer, a little bit down my nose. Some Ardell lashes number 122, and now the problem. I tried a pinky nude and it was just awful, so I was like, ugh, not happening. So I went back to the original idea with the orange and it was clashing with the shirt. So I ended up with Pacifica Nudie Red, which I got in my Ipsy Glam bag this month. And that's it.
So this is it. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you have a wonderful Christmas with your family and friends and everything else. And put some makeup on, play with some makeup and try to recreate these looks. It's a lot of fun. It's not as crazy as it seems. It's not as intense as it seems. I wasn't born knowing how to do all this, so it's just a little bit of practice. You know, I always say before you take a shower, play with a little bit of makeup. You know, if it looks good, you take a picture. If it looks bad, you take a shower. So I hope, again, you have a wonderful Christmas. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I can't say that word, but it's okay. You can subscribe. It's a little red button down there. And share it with your friends. And also follow me on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter and all that good stuff. And Snapchat. I really like Snapchat. So, yes. All right. Bye-bye.